Have you ever wondered what it takes to be absolutely great at something? Well, this week, Kobe Bryant offered a masterclass, the 6 steps to have the greatness mindset that he has. Now, if you don't know what happened earlier this week, an NBA player named Gordon Hayward was in a horrific injury 6 minutes into the very first game of the season. And it was one of those injuries where his leg was going this way and his ankle was going this way. He's out for the entire season. Now, you don't have to know anything about basketball for this to mean something to you, because back in 2013, Kobe Bryant had a third-degree tear in his Achilles tendon and had to go through months and months of terrible recovery in order to get back to playing basketball. And for some, those types of injuries could be season-ending, they could be career-ending, and they could be life-changing. Some athletes never recover from an injury like that. But some athletes come back better than they ever were. And so you might ask yourself, why is that? And I'm gonna take you through the process, but first I'm gonna read you the post that he had to Gordon Hayward. He says, "Be sad, be mad, be frustrated, scream, cry, sulk. When you wake up, you will think that it was just a nightmare, only to realize that it's all too real. You will be angry and wish for that day back, the game back, that play back. But reality gives you nothing back, nor should you. Time to move on and focus on doing everything in your power to prepare for surgery. Ask all the questions to be sure that you understand fully the procedure so that you may visualize it in your subconscious while being operated on and better the chance of its success. Then focus on the recovery process day by day by day. It's a long journey, but if you focus on the many milestones along the way, you will find beauty in the struggle of doing the simple things prior to this injury that were taken for granted. This will also mean that when you return, you will have a new perspective. You will be so appreciative of being able to stand, walk, and run that you will train harder than you ever have. You will see the belief within you grow with each mini milestone, and you will come back a better player for it. Best of luck to you on this journey, my brother." So there's 6 parts in this post that I want to talk about. Number one, be human. Be sad, be mad, be pissed off, cry and sulk. Allow yourself to feel the human emotions that you need to, because all too often something will happen and we try to forget about it and we don't allow ourselves to actually experience the emotions that we should as human. So the first thing he says is be human. Allow yourself to feel those emotions. The second thing that he says is it's time to move on. He says you'll want that playback, you'll want that day back, that game back, but you can never get it back. You can never change the past. So after something happens and you allow yourself to feel the emotions, get over it, because you can't change the past. The only thing that you can change is this present moment. And by changing your attitude and your work ethic in this present moment, it will then change your future and make your future better. Number three, he says to visualize what you want. He says be sure to fully understand the surgery so that you can visualize it in your subconscious, which gives you a better chance of actually having success throughout the surgery. And this is a big one, because most people don't think about visualization in their process to success. But there's 2 things that you need to know about visualization and why it's important. The first reason why is because it actually makes it very clear to you when you visualize every day what it is that you want, but it also makes it very clear the path to get there to achieve what you want. So that's the first thing about visualization. The second part about visualization is it actually makes you more excited to get there, because when you open your eyes, you realize you're still in the exact same moment, but you've already seen the future. You've already seen what the future could look like. That gives you drive. That gives you motivation to work harder for what it is that you actually want. Number four, take it day by day. Kobe says, take your recovery day by day by day. Because all too often, we already want to be in our goal. We already want to be into the future, but we can't be there. So what do we have to do? We have to focus on today, on getting better today. We can't think about the future and how badly we want to be there. What we need to do is focus on being better today than we were yesterday. So the only real goal that you should have is when you go to bed tonight, you ask yourself this question: am I better tonight than when I woke up this morning? And if you do that every single day, you'll see massive changes of how much better you become. Number five, he says enjoy the process. He says you'll start to enjoy and appreciate the little tiny mini milestones along the way. And you'll find beauty in the struggle of doing simple things. And this is big, because most extremely successful people do it for this reason. They're not focused on becoming rich. Because if you think about it, Mark Zuckerberg and Warren Buffett, Jeff Bezos, Mark Cuban, all of these people, they don't need to work to make money, because money was never their focus. It was the end goal, or the goal of changing the world, or the goal of becoming better every single day. They enjoy the process and the challenges that come along the way. And number six, he says, be appreciative. He says you'll be so much more appreciative, be able to stand, to walk, to run. Because all too often, we don't appreciate and we're not grateful for the things that we do have around us. We're not grateful enough for the fact that we have air to breathe and food and water and shelter and clothing. If you're watching this video, you have the internet. We always want more, 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 but we're never actually appreciative and grateful for what we do have. Sometimes it takes something catastrophic for us to put our life into perspective. But you don't have to have something happen to you like that today. Today you can sit back and look at all the things that you have to be grateful for. So although this seemed like a nice note to a friend, this was actually a 6-step masterclass into the mindset of what it takes to be great. So now that you know what it takes to be great, what are you going to become great at?